Samantha Bacall at The Oregonian. Welcome back to Taste Test, where I eat things, or in this case, drink things on camera and tell you how they are. Today I am tasting my least favorite holiday drink, eggnog. And there are a lot of reasons why I don't like eggnog, and most of them center around the fact that it kind of has like a cold snot consistency, and it normally smells like bubblegum. But today we're trying four different kinds. I've got a bottle of our carton of the Alpenrose. We have an organic kind from Organic Valley, a glass bottle from Gary's Meadow, which is a local dairy producer, and a carton from Silks. So that's a dairy-free soy-based one. And I saw today I had to draw the line at eggnog kefir. I figured if you're drinking kefir flavored like eggnog, you're just drinking it because you like the flavor of eggnog, not because you want a dairy alternative. So we're gonna start with the Alpenrose, and it's really thick when I poured it out, and I'm not looking forward to it, and it's maybe the grossest looking one that I poured out. So, and it has like a minty bubblegum smell to it. Well, it's certainly more mild than I thought it would be, but the consistency is really gross. It's really thick, and I don't know, dairy products, unless they're yogurt, shouldn't have that kind of hesitant consistency to want to go into my mouth. The next one we're doing is the organic one from Organic Valley, and it's a lot lighter. Actually looks more like milk than the other ones. So we'll see how, and this one also kind of has that same smell, not as strong. That one actually just tastes like milk with some spices in it, so I maybe would consider drinking that one, especially if you added some bourbon or, you know, something a little bit stronger to it. The next one we're trying is from Gary's Meadow, which I was really excited to find. I love their milk. They do beautiful cream and half and half and chocolate milk as well. So excited to see that they did an eggnog. And I actually had to shake the bottle when I was pouring it out because a lot of the spice sediment kind of had all settled at the bottom. So it's a good sign. So it also smells less like bubblegum. But it tastes like bubblegum. It's just that, ugh. It's kind of like cloying in your mouth, and it kind of like coats your throat when you're drinking it, and it's really gross. The last one we're doing is from Silk, which is the dairy-free version. So if anybody's, you know, not lactose intolerant, or, you know, you're just trying to avoid milk for a little bit, this is a good option if you'd still like to drink eggnog. And this one's actually a lot thinner than the other ones, which I prefer because, you know, eggnog shouldn't be super thick, but smells very similar to the other ones. Yeah, not terrible. You know, doesn't have as strong of a taste, but I would definitely, you know, pick that one over some of the other ones we've had, so. Don't have anything planned for next week, but if you've got any tips or something you'd like to see me eat on camera, whether I like it or not, feel free to send me an email or comment below.